Hello children, how are you all? Hope you all are doing well. I'm here with the second part from our second chapter of chemistry, that is matter around us pure? Previously we have covered what is a mixture and types of mixture. Today we will cover what is a solution and concentration of a solution. Now coming to what is a solution. We all know that when we combine two substances together and keeping one substance in a liquid form, then it results in the formation of a solution. But as we are the students of chemistry, we'll study the definition and everything in a proper systematic language form. Now, solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances. Homogeneous means the substance which is having same composition throughout. Okay, so when two or more substances are combined together and it forms a homogeneous mixture, it results in the formation of a solution. The best example we have is a soda water and a lemonade. The whole concentration is the same throughout the particular thing. Now, to know about homogeneous mixture, the best example is of alloys, which are the homogeneous mixture of metal or a mixture of a metal and a non-metal or another element which cannot be separated into their components by any of the physical method. Now, if we talk about alloy, then we know that the properties of its constituent of its mixture is always same. There is no change. Like if we talk about the example, then steel, which is a combination of iron and a carbon. Similarly, bronze, which is a combination of copper and tin. And then we have a brass, which is a mixture of 70% copper and 30% zinc. Here metal and non-metal, metal and metal, all are present for the formation of the alloys. Now coming to a solution. So a solution is made up of two components. The one is a solvent and another one is a solute. The component of a solution that dissolves the other component in it, usually which is present in large quantity, is known as solvent. Normally solvent is always in the liquid form, and we know water is a universal solvent. Then a component of the solution that is dissolved in the solvent, which is usually present in less quantity or amount, is called a solute. Here is a diagrammatic representation. Like when we combine water, which is a solvent, and sugar as a solute, then we get a solution of sugar. Here we can even take the example of water and lime juice, like water and soda, water and sugar, anything. Now coming to the examples of a solution. So best example is a solution of sugar in water, in which we are adding a solid in a liquid form and forming a solution. Then we have a solution of iodine in alcohol, which is known as tincture iodine, which is used as an antiseptic for the wound healing. Here iodine is a solid form, which is brownish in color, and which is solute also, and alcohol is a liquid, which is solvent. We can take another example of the aerated drinks like soda water, Coca-Cola and etc., which are gaseous in nature and which are dissolved in a liquid form. So the content carbon dioxide which is present in the soda water in a gaseous form is solute, and water liquid is a solvent. Another best universal example is of air, which is a mixture of gas in which different components like oxygen, nitrogen are present, and they all are in a homogeneous form. Now there are certain properties of a solution which we refer. First of all, solution is a homogeneous mixture. Then the particles of solution are smaller than 1 nanometer, that is 10 to the power minus 9 meter in diameter. So they cannot be seen through our neck dyes. As they are very small in size, they do not scatter beam of light passing through them. So the path of light is not visible in a solution. That means a solution is there, and when we'll pass light through a torch, then there will be no visibility of the path, or light will not pass through the solution. Next point, the solute particles cannot be separated from the mixture by a physical process like filtration. The solute particles do not settle down when left undisturbed, that is, solution is stable. Now, why solute particles does not get settled down? Because they get mixed up and then they form a homogeneous mixture. Coming to the concentration of a solution. Now, basically, so for knowing the concentration of a solution, we need to study about solubility. If we talk about solubility, then it is the property of showing the ability of a given substance in which solute is dissolved in a solvent. That means, ek substance ki ability hoti hai ki solute or solvent ke form mein dissolve hone ki. Now, it is a mixture in terms of the maximum amount of solute dissolved in a solvent known as saturated solution. Now, solubility can be measured in three forms: saturated solution, dilute solution and concentrated solution. So, here definition of saturated solution is given. That is measured in the maximum amount of solute dissolved in a solvent. Coming to factors affecting. Now, there are two factors which affect the solubility: temperature and pressure. Solubility increases with the temperature. The situation is different for gases in which temperature may become less soluble in each other and water, but more soluble in organic solvents. Coming to next, pressure. Now, coming to pressure. Now, for majority of solid and liquid solutes, pressure does not affect, but gas is directly proportional to the solubility. Like, agar temperature increase karenge to solubility badhegi, wahi gas ke andar hum pressure ko badhayenge to uski solubility directly proportional rahegi. Coming to types of solution on the basis of the concentration of the solution: dilute solution, concentrated solution and saturated solution. Now, dilute solution in which amount of solvent is more than amount of solute. Concentrated solution is the one in which amount of solute is more than amount of solvent. And saturated solution is the one in which solute is dissolved in a solvent at a maximum temperature. Coming to activity 2.3 from our NCERT textbook, in which you have to take 50 ml of water in two beakers A and B. In the beaker 1, you have to add either salt or sugar, and in the beaker 2, B, you have to add barium chloride. There will be a state where no more solute will be dissolved. In this condition, you have to heat this solution. As you will heat the solution, then their capacity of adding more solute will increase. Now, at a particular temperature of the solution does not, in simple terms we can say that ek particular temperature ke upar jo solution rehta hai, wo ek limit se zyada solute ko dissolve nahi karta hai, and that is known as a saturated solution. In other words, we can say when no more solute can be dissolved in a solution at a given temperature. At a given temperature is called saturated solution. Temperature hum bada nahi rahe, kam nahi kar rahe, but the given temperature jo bhi hai, us pe jab solute aur add na ho. Like when, suppose if your mother is asking you to make a lemon juice. So what, sabse pehle hum, we are adding sugar in the water and we are dissolving. Then sometimes it happens that sugar stops dissolving in the water. But when you increase the amount of water, it dissolves. So similarly, ke ek given temperature or amount pe jab tak solute dissolve aage jaake hona band hota hai, that is saturated state. Ab jab hum us saturated state ko thoda sa heat kar denge, to particles jo rahenge aur dissolve hona start. Now coming to the definition of solubility in unsaturated solution. The amount of solute present in the saturated solution at that particular temperature is known as solubility. Jitna bhi us particular temperature pe solute add hoga, like 1 teaspoon, 2 teaspoon, 5 grams, 10 grams, 20 grams, that will be the solubility at that particular temperature of that particular solution. Now, if the amount of solute contained in a solution is less than the saturated level, it is called unsaturated. Matlab, aisi condition in which like water is there and you are adding sugar, adding. So, condition where more sugar can be added, that condition at a given temperature is known as unsaturated solution. Now, that was about the definition. If we talk about the activity, now we can infer from the above activity that different substances in a given solvent have different solubilities at the same temperature. Alag-alag substances ki same temperature pe alag-alag solubility hoti hai. Salt will have different solubilities, sugar will have different solubility, barium chloride, sodium chloride will have different solubility. The concentration of a solute in the amount of solute, sorry, the concentration of a solution in a given amount of solute present, the concentration of a solution is the amount of solute present in a given amount of solution. Or we can say jo amount of solute rehta hai ga, wo given mass ya volume ke according solvent mein add hota hai, wo ek particular solution ka concentration hota hai. Here again I have written the same definition. You need to learn these things. That is why again I have written in a separate form. Coming to concentration of solution. The concentration of solution, we know it is measured in the solute and solvent form. Jab ek solute or solvent hame pata hota, toh we come to know about the concentration. So there are two formulas which are applied depending upon the numerical. The first one is amount of solute divided by amount of solution, or amount of solute divided by amount of solvent. Now, jab solute and solution given hai, toh that will be the formula whichever thing is asked. Like if they are asking for the concentration of the percentage of solution, so the upper one formula will be there. If they are asking for the solvent, then solute and solvent formula will be applied. There are two ways of representing concentration of a solution. The first one is for mass by mass percentage. The second one is for mass by volume percentage. Now, mass by mass percentage of a solution is calculated as mass of solute upon or divided by mass of solution into 100. Then, for mass by volume percentage of a solution is defined by mass of solute divided by volume of solution into 100. To explain this, I'll be explaining one of the example from our NCERT book itself. The example says that a solution containing 40 gram of common salt in 320 gram of water. Now 40 gram of common salt in 320 gram of water. Water over here is solvent and salt over here is a solute. That means solute water ke andar salt ko add kara. Now what we have to do, we have to calculate the concentration in terms of mass by mass percentage of the solution. Hame mass by mass percentage of the solution padhna hai. So mass by mass percentage of solution kya kehta hai? Mass of solute divided by mass of solution into 100. But here we are not knowing the mass of solution. So to know the mass of solution, what we will do? We will add solute and solvent. That means 320 plus 40 grams. So we will get 360 grams. Then we will apply the particular formula of mass percentage of solution, that is mass of solute upon mass of solution into 100. For that, what we'll do, solute kitna hai? 40, and solution is 360 multiplied by 100, then we will get the particular answer. This was one of the example from our this chapter. Topic solution In my next PPT, I will be giving you more examples which will be helpful for your exam also. This was all. If you face any doubt, then you please feel free to contact through Campus Care. Okay? Till here, read from the NCERT book again and again. If you face any query or doubt, you can please message me on Campus Care. Regarding voice also, you are free to message on the Campus Care. Please do message and clear your doubt. Till I come with my next topic, stay safe, stay home, listen to your parents. Bye-bye.